Okay guys, so today's video is going to be about what you need to be testing for the stripes. So I'm basically gonna go through all the skills that you need from yellow stripe, for the orange stripe, for green stripe, blue stripe, brown stripe, and black stripe, okay? So first thing first, for the yellow stripes, this segment of the video is for who's testing to get a yellow stripe, okay? First is gonna be the stances. We're gonna go and find the first stance, which is Heisoku Dachi. Your feet are completely together. Toes and heels are touching, all right? Second stance, stance number two, is gonna be Musubi Dachi. Musubi Dachi is like a V. Your feet are on angle, toes pointing out, heels touching still, okay? The third stance, Soto Achi Dachi, we use for the little ones, Jigotai. Okay, a little wider than the shoulders. You guys always say it at the dojo. Sounds cool, right? Jigotai. The next one is going to be Chikodachi. Okay, Chikodachi is where you're on the same width of Jigotai. Bend your knees. Okay, toes pointing out, knees and toes on the same angle. Chikodachi. Okay, number four, stance. Now we're gonna go back. We're gonna start practicing our techniques, okay? From now, we're gonna be working on Jigotai. Stance number three, Jigotai. First one, switching punches, all right? Or Sonobasuki. All right, as you realize, I'm punching right in the middle of my chest every single time. Get close, please. So, right here, we're gonna be punching on the exact same spot every time. And make sure that you're extending the knuckles out. We don't want our wrist to be bent up and punch with our fingers. It's a very common habit for beginners. Knuckles always out and extended. Okay, you wanna make sure that the forearm comes all the way flat from the top, okay? And every single punch comes to the exact same spot that the last punch. Always on the same spot, okay? Then we have Nidansuki, double punch. Every punch, same spot. Knuckles, same form, okay? Then we got Sambonsuki, triple punch. Three long punches, never shorter, right? Three complete long punches. You can go back. Three long punches. Every single punch on the exact same spot. Good. Now, we're gonna have first block, Jodan Uke or rising block, okay? Now, make sure when you do your Jodan Uke or rising block, your block comes right across your face and the elbow is what makes the deflection. We don't block like this, right? We block like this, okay? And the hand that is blocking, coming up, comes outside. The hand that is already up, pulls in on the inside. Little details for beginners. Make sure you block correctly. Make sure you block correctly. Then we have Gedan Marai. Down block, hand comes across your chest, and block down. Cross, switch. Okay, and the last thing that we're gonna work on is the front kick, or my getting. Make sure that our hands have elbows in front of our ribs, hands even. Again, Jigotai, we pick our knee out straight, right in front of our belt level, all right? We are not gonna kick upwards, we want to kick forward, right? Hands always up here, elbows locked, kick straight. Make sure your toes are pulled back, because you wanna kick with the ball of your foot. If we wanna get close, so I want you to kick with the ball of the foot, forward, 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 okay? When you kick and pull back, kick and pull back, always forward. The next next segment, we're gonna be working on what you need to test for orange stripe, okay? First thing, again, staying on jigotai, we're gonna work on soto uke, outside block, okay? Hands by your side, one hand comes all the way across your stomach, make sure you cover all of your chest. One, two, right? And keep your elbow lined up with your ribs. We never wanna block outside. We wanna keep our hand lined up with your shoulder. Chu down or medium level soto uke, outside block. One, hand goes under, one. The hand that is down here, always on front. Remember, when we block, the hand that is blocking always goes on front. Torso rotation is important. Don't exaggerate, but don't do it like this, or you're gonna keep your body rigid, okay? You want body to rotate, okay? Now, next one that we're gonna be working on is a round kick. As usual, I want you to get your round kick. We do it from jigotai, hand across your stomach, hand up, okay? We're gonna pick our knee up, straight knee or front knee, one, kick and back, right? Make sure that our kick has the whole full form. On this one, we're gonna kick with the top of the foot. So make sure that you're kicking out with your toes down, get the top of your foot, especially the bottom of your shin, which is really hard so you can get a strong impact, okay? One, two, and back, okay? One, and back, okay? Make sure that we don't kick like this and drop it down straight. Form is important. Once you're done with one side, flip the other way, make sure that you use your other leg, okay? So you wanna do both legs. Okay, mawashigeri or round kick. Next thing that we're gonna be working on for the orange stripes, or testing for orange stripe, is the chikodachi. Chikodachi or horse stance. Okay, remember, from jigotai, bend your knees, knees and toes on the same angle, on your heels, back straight, squeezing your glutes, okay? Nobody like this. Everybody stand up, straight here, press tight. Okay, now from horse stance or here, you guys might be asked to do some punches or some block just to see if you can control your stance and stay still. Although no specific technique is required, as long as you do your chikodachi correctly with your hands off your legs. Next one is gonna be senkutsudachi or front stance. A good way to learn this one, like I said, from musubidachi or stance number two, don't move this foot. Move the other leg forward, all right? When we do senkutsudachi, we wanna make sure that our front knee is bent, okay? We don't want the leg across. So when you're here and you come straight, make sure that you go a little bit to the side, okay? Never across like this, that leads to bad balance, okay? If you need to measure your stance, if you need to measure it, bring your knee down on your toes on the back foot. You're gonna have two fists wide in between your knee and your heel, and one fist of length in between them. Okay, right here two fists, and one fist in between the knee and the heel forward. This way, okay? That's how you make sure that your stance is correct. Now, we're gonna be moving up on the curriculum for the requirements that you will need to test for the green stripe. Now, to get the green stripe, first thing that we're gonna do is a few front stance little things. Again, we set two front stance, punching in place or sonobatsuki. We're gonna be here, jodan junsuki, and chudan yakosuki, without moving your feet. Always straight, very strong, very fast, and very precise. Straight line, middle, middle, face, chest. Then you will be required to switch your feet and do the same. Jodan, chunan. Jodan, chunan. Okay? Front stance or senkutsudachi. Next thing, front senkutsudachi or front stance, we're gonna do a front kick. high Geri. Make sure we kick, back. Kick, back, okay? You gotta be able to do this perfectly balanced. We don't want to be able to kick and then get all wobbly to make our way back. Keep your body straight, one and back, okay? Again, we make sure that we can do both sides. Got it? Next thing is going to be a Yakosuki or reverse punch. From your fighting stance, we want to be able to Yakosuki, Yakosuki, out and back, okay? All of you guys know this. And as usual, both sides. Pull back as fast as you can, use your hips to reach very deep. Don't move your guard. Keep your guard strong up. One, two, okay? And the last thing, okay, or the only real thing that you gotta do technique-wise, new, is gonna be your uchi uke, inside block, okay? So here, on jigotai, we wanna make sure that we can show correct inside block. Make sure your fist is somewhat pointing up. Your elbow should be kind of like on the same line of your belly button. And you want to block all the way across your body, all the way. Okay? That is all for the green stripe, the requirement for the blue stripe. First is going to be standing side kick or sokutogeri. Sokutogeri, you got to pick your knee up like it's a front kick or maigeri, right? Your knee comes up straight, keep your body lined up. Obviously, look to the side. We always look when we do a technique. And extend your foot sideways, okay? You want to extend your foot with the edge of it and basically getting your heel outwards, okay? Your heel and the edge. This is called sokuto, the side of your foot, okay? Towards the heel, especially, is a little harder, so you wanna keep with your toes, okay? Like I said, foot comes up, out, back, and down. Front, right, one, and down. One, and down. So you wanna do it quick. That is sokuto or side kick. Next one is going to be nagashi uke. Nagashi uke or sweep and block. What we're going to do is our hand is going to block with the edge of your hand. This is not a very effective block to be standing, so we want to make sure to educate our body to rotate with your block, okay? Use the teisho or edge of your hand, heel of your hand, to hit across your body. The hand on your side remains closed, the other hand comes open, and across. Then we close this hand opens up, and across. See how I turn my torso? Don't pass your hand away. Keep it lined up with the edge of your body. Whatever that you're blocking over here is not gonna hurt you. So there's no reason for you to create more openings on your back. Stay here. Got it? Make sure teisho is up. The heel of your hand strikes as you avoid, right? That is the nagashi uke. And now, from zenkutsu dachi or front stance, we do mawashi geri. We're gonna do them with both legs. So if you're in a fighting stance, you gotta be able to do one or two. One, two, both legs, front leg, back leg. Okay, switch your feet like usual, front leg or back leg. Front leg or back leg. Got it? Go away. Okay, from now on, we're gonna see the requirement for a brown stripe. For the brown stripe, what you will need to do is, first, we're gonna work on chikō dachi. And from chikodachi, you gotta be able to do a perfect front kick and always set up back to the same position. This is something we always work in the dojo, but you gotta make sure that you go back to the same position. It's a very common habit on training, to do this and then end up doing different stances. We want to always end up same, 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 same. Also, make sure that your position, sorry, make sure that your knee comes right straight up from your position, from Chikolachi. Okay, work in and down, in, down, okay? Chikodachi. Second requirement, from Senkutsudachi or front stance, 1-2, Tobijaku, okay? Make sure to elongate, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, right? Tobijaku, Tobi Komisuki, Yakusuki. As usual, we switch your feet, make sure you work both sides of your body. Last requirement for a round strike. Okay, what you gotta do is 1-2 front leg washigeri. So it has to be right. Make sure that as usual, switch your feet. Got it? Last thing is going to be requirement for a block strike. First thing that we're going to learn is everything that we're going to be doing is moving. We're going to learn how to do moving basics. So as usual, we're going to start with your left leg forward. Idari no kamai. Front punch with your left punch, left leg forward, okay? Step in without bringing your head up or stomping up. We want to slide. Okay, when we do a front punch, or yunsuki, we want to turn, jaw down, okay. Rise and lock. Second requirement is going to be a maigeri or front kick. Moving forward, always landing in good position. Never short, never too long, never too bent. Same position. As we're in fighting stance, we turn into fighting stance. Maigeri, right? Front kick. Last one is going to be my washigeri. Round kick. Always moving forward, like I said. Keep a good base, a good solid position. Domo arigato gozaimasu. That is all what is required for testing on the stripe belts, okay? Curriculum is not very extensive, but it is very detailed. So you have to be able to cover it up if you want to be able to move to the solid belts. So see you guys in our next videos or at the dojo hopefully very soon.